I want to welcome for you Jump 5. Give them a big hand clap as they come.
It's about friends, it's about school, it's about changes, the ones you never thought they put you through. It's times like these that I got a touch of Irish in me, yeah. And we can talk honesty, but honestly, I'm okay this way, yeah. Hey, you just don't understand. Sometimes my sky's a little gray, and I know eventually I'll be feeling alright again, yeah. Life's been a friend to me, and you don't need to convince me. It's a beautiful world. It's about faith, it's about heart, it's about progress, the things that try to tear the world apart.
My mind has just me,
cause I feel what I feel, much too deep, but even motivates me to do something good, and I'm okay this way.
It's a beautiful world. I know it's a beautiful world.
Give it up for Jump Five. Give it up for these guys. What, you guys make me tired just looking at you.
Oh, and what's your, tell everybody your name.
I'm Chris.
Hey, Chris. And are you tired right now?
I can't breathe.
are you out of breath?
I'm a little bit, but not much.
And what's your name?
Brittany.
And you are?
Leslie.
And I'm Brandon.
Brandon, good to meet you guys. I met you a little bit earlier, but and you see, at home, you didn't realize you were going to get to kind of do a little workout kind of ministry, and hope you were keeping time with these guys. And so, how did you guys learn to dance like that?
We've been dancing and singing together since we were really young, about 3 and 4 years old. So
you all have been friends for a long time.
Mm-hmm. Long time.
Is that right? And so you're, how old are you? Just.
I'm 19.
19.
16.
16.
18.
So you guys are young people, reaching out to your generation, ministering to young people, even though you're out of breath, you know. And somebody tell me about how you got turned on to Jesus. How'd you get, you know, just fired up for him?
Well, I think all of us did it in different ways. Like I started in my family's a Christian family, but I never really had that relationship like I do now until it was like a friend of mine who was my age, and they helped me come more to Jesus, which is really cool because it's not always, you know, older people helping kids. It's kids helping kids sometimes. And that's why we wanted to do what we do. And we've been doing it since we were 9 and 10. So we feel like we've accomplished that.
That's awesome. And you guys have had all this exposure and Disney and this kind of thing. So how has it been like for your head? Like, how do you stay humble when you have all this exposure and you're traveling everywhere and all this?
Well, I think the exciting thing for us is, you know, we get to go do the secular shows, the Disney shows, Nickelodeon, all that stuff. But then we gain fans there, and then we go do shows in churches. And so it's very humbling to, you know, be able to turn people onto Christ, because they may not necessarily know we're a Christian group, because our songs can be taken either way. They can be saying, you know, I'm worshiping God, or thanks to a friend, or so you can take them in different ways. So, you know, when they come to the Christian shows, the church shows, then they really see what we're all about.
I think another thing that keeps us humble is, like, our friends and family. They don't treat us any different. Like, before we came here, we all live in Nashville, so it's not too far of a drive. And, like, I, like, clean the house today and stuff. So it's not like we have, like, this high life where we don't do things.
So your mom and dad don't, like, do all the stuff for you?
No.
No.
Good. See? Moms and dads, you can do it too. Now, okay, now I heard you guys been on some international trips with Compassion and World Vision and stuff. Like, tell me how that has affected you going on an international trip and seeing how people live around the world.
I was just going to say that I think you never really know, like, how things are unless you go experience it for yourself. Because, like, we were all, man, that's horrible what's going on over in different countries. But it never came, like, into color until we actually went over there and met the kids and got to know their lives. And it's so much. Like, if you have the opportunity to go, we would definitely recommend it.
Yeah, it's an eye-opening experience. And it's... You know, it's everybody needs to experience that at least once in a while.
These kids and these families have nothing, but like when we went in and, you know, met the kids and sang for them, all they wanted to do was give us their stuff. They wanted to give us their only stuffed animal, their only, you know, and we're like,
those presents are so cool.
It's amazing to see how little they have, but how much they want to give and how much how happy they are and loving.
So, what did it do to your heart when you saw kids like that?
Ooh.
We were in a way you're kind of like, man, I have it made, because we have a great family. We have a great home that we don't have to, you know, tend to as much as they do. And, like, we went to one house where there was, how many people were living in it?
25.
And it was, like, not even close to the size of my house. And I don't even have a big house. It's just amazing, like, the way they live.
You definitely realize how much you take for granted, especially when you get right, when the day you get back from a trip like that, you just want to go into your closet and just throw away all the stuff and just give it all away. But definitely an eye-opener.
Yeah, it was very hard for us. We weren't even there for very long, and we were worn out after like 2 days of doing it, just because it's so hard to see and to experience.
Right. So. Well, let me just encourage you. I mean, you guys sound like you're overwhelmed with when you went, what happened in your life. And, you know, there are a lot of mission trips that go out in the summertime. Global Expeditions, we have a bunch of kids out, and Teen Mania trips, but there's a lot of other trips as well. And so you guys would recommend teenagers your age? You don't have to wait till you're old or whatever to do something?
I say do it when you're young.
Good. So you heard that? Mom's dad? You think moms and dads should let their kids go?
Of course.
Yeah. Don't be afraid. God will take care of them. And it'll change your life as well, change your kids' life. And a lot of parents are like, I wish I could get my kids to be on fire. But then they're afraid to let them go to Costa Rica or some other. Right. Just let them go for 2 weeks or for a month. It will change them forever. And you'll be reaping that fruit for the rest of your life. Now, you guys can do another song. Is that right?
Yes.
You're not too tired?
No.
Sure? Okay. Give it up for Jump Five one more time.
you don't.